Let's start that last episode, finally. Oh, stand by. Let me. Okay.
This is a consequence of your actions, Chloe. We both agree that the best thing for everyone at this stage is for me to move in.
In a million years, I never thought you'd choose David over me.
Hey!
Blackwell's done with me. I can't go home anymore. Is this junkyard all I've got left?
Drew runs Oxy for Damon. Go to Drew's room, find the money, and I'll meet you to pick it up.
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
Oh, I want my fucking money!
Juliet is wailing. That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel.
No fucking chance. I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish? Yes. Let's leave. For real. If you don't mean this, it's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen. What would it take to convince you? Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?
Rachel, that woman you saw, that wasn't my mistress.
That was your mother.
That was your mother.
Bum, bum, bum.
I want to tell you all of it. But are you sure that Chloe should be here for...
Chloe stays.
Of course. In every way that matters, Rose is my wife and your mother. But the woman you saw at the Overlook, her name is Sarah. Your birth mother. I'm going to tell you everything, Rachel. Everything I've shielded you from for so long. But the truth can be hard to look at. Is this really something you're ready for?
Chloe.
In high school, there was one person everyone adored. Her teachers, her friends. Sarah was everyone's favorite. Every boy wanted to date her. I could barely believe it when she picked me. Sometimes, I think that's what kept me blind for so long. She was so alive, so passionate about everything. Early on, though, I realized I wasn't enough for her. rest of us were pursuing college, careers, families. Sarah wasn't looking for any of that. She was looking for escape.
She was so beautiful, just like you.
I only saw what I wanted to see. Until it was almost... When Sarah became pregnant, I thought it would solve everything. And it did. For a little while. Becoming your father. The greatest moment of my life. There was so much love, but I was still blind. However much she loved you then, it wasn't enough. For Sarah, the need to escape was always there. To help her. I made myself believe that she was still a good person. That no matter what happened, she would never do anything to hurt you. I was wrong. Eventually, I saw her for who she really was. A destructive person. Someone who could never be satisfied. Anyone or anything. Even the love of her own daughter. I was desperate. I didn't know what to do. So I made a choice. I was never going to let her harm you again. What you saw at the Overlook, Rachel, it was true. We kissed. The saddest kiss of my life. It was a kiss goodbye. I told her, and I was happy for her, that she felt like she'd gotten her life together. Finally. But she didn't get to just decide one day to be a mother. Not after what she'd done, but after all the people she hurt. The lives she destroyed. I told her she'd been given the greatest gift in the world, the chance to be your mother. And she squandered it. It pained me to hurt her like that. But I'd do it again and again. And again, to keep you safe.
And Rachel was exactly the same.
So that was the first time you've seen her or spoken with her in 15 years?
No. I send her money. Every single month. Our arrangement.
But now she wants to see me?
Yes. But Rachel, it cannot be.
Why not? If that's what Rachel wants.
Drug addiction is a disease. It afflicts everyone, not just the addict. I will not allow you to be victimized by her disease again.
Even if that's true, Rachel could still meet her.
And maybe the fact that she wants to see me means she's gotten better.
Maybe so. But consider that for 15 years, she's preferred that money to you.
Rachel.
I think I need to lie down.
Solid 60 frames, that's pretty good.
This must be hard for you too, Mr. Amber.
It could be far worse. My biggest fear is that Rachel will try to meet Sarah. I've dreaded it.
So that's why you never told her?
You have no idea what pain Sarah's caused. Her addiction has led her to do terrible things. I don't want Rachel to go through any of that.
I don't understand. Are you afraid that Sarah would do something to Rachel?
I don't think she would deliberately harm anyone. But addicts can cause tremendous harm without meaning to.
Yeah. Rachel's not a baby anymore.
Listen to me. Sarah brought criminals and drug dealers into our home. She put Rachel in serious danger just to chase her habit. Chloe, I believe Rachel trusts you more than anyone else right now.
Is this where you ask me to manipulate Rachel into doing what you want?
This is where I ask you to do as your conscience dictates. But please, put my daughter's safety first.
Maybe try the truth for a change?
What do you mean?
Well, you did lie to your daughter for 15 years.
This is true. And that's why I need your help. I only care about Rachel, Chloe.
I'll do what I can. I care about her too, you know?
I know. Thank you.
Where's the mother? There she is.
Hey, Mrs. Amber.
I think it's Rose at this point, considering everything.
Okay. Rose. Do you need any help with anything?
That's very kind of you. Could you get out the broom for me? It's in the breezeway. Door to the left of the fridge.
Here you go.
Thank you. I'm really quite glad that you're here.
Thanks. But why?
While Rachel's dealing with all of this, It's a relief to know she can talk to you. How are you doing, Chloe?
How am I doing?
Your generation loves to talk about how awkward different things are. Well, this must be pretty awkward, I'd imagine.
It's fine. Rachel's the one who's really upset.
She has every reason to be. There are many painful things about Rachel's past, including my own role in hiding the truth.
Sarah shouldn't have taken money over seeing her daughter.
You know, I am so thankful to her that she did. It gave me the opportunity to be Rachel's mother. I never knew how much I could love someone until I had Rachel.
But hearing the truth after all these years hurt Rachel more than anything.
I'm not happy with James for the whole way this came out.
You're not happy with James? What about what he did at the Overlook?
It might be hard for you to understand, but after 13 years of marriage, I'm not threatened by what happened.
You're right. I don't understand.
You don't have to worry about me or James. Rachel's the one who needs you right now.
Do you think Sarah is dangerous?
I've never met her, so I don't know. But I'm inclined to trust my husband. His entire life is about keeping people safe. Rachel's extremely fortunate to have him as her father.
Thanks.
Thank you, Chloe.
Hard to argue that Rachel would have had a better life with... some way to show Rachel that I'm here for her. Rachel's surrounded by so much love, yet she seems so alone. Rachel even knows how to make a dinky lamp look cool. Makes sense that Rachel needs two signs to contain her awesomeness. I shall call her Lion Crab from now on. This light needs more light. Wonder what I could find around here to brighten up that night. Is there a section on how to walk fours through batshit crazy family drama? No?
Mm-hmm.
I could get grades like this. I just don't want to. I know something Miss Arcadia doesn't. Weird. At least she'll have something from tonight. I think Rachel could use another subject. But which one? That's the one. Ready for Rachel's light show. Wish there was some way to make this brighter. Hey, check it out. It's beautiful. I thought you might like it. I've always loved stars. Why? They remind us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see. Because we're blinded by what's in front of us. Exactly. But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years. They're all lies. That doesn't make them any less beautiful, right? I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point? It's all lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore. And that other woman, my real mom, she's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust.
I don't know. I bet there's, like, one other chick in Australia who's super trustworthy.
No chance. You're one in 100 infinities, Clovis. I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked for it. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone.
the fact that she's here right now. That she came here. I think I need to see her. Is that wrong?
Honestly, I have no idea what's right or wrong in this situation. I just know that whatever you decide, I'm in.
What if we can't find her? Still, like, I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start.
I think I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You do that?
We'll give it a shot.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
I think I might be able to fix up that truck in the junkyard.
Really?
I'll give it my best.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak, I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams. He's there. And it's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking.
Hey, Pyronella.
Maybe I was wrong before.
Have you had a Merry Christmas?
Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right. Stuck. Hey, maybe you should let me drive. You always do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go?
Remember when we used to work on cars together? Those are some of my favorite memories.
Never. That wasn't you.
Could have sworn that was me. All right, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
Thank you. What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
Fine. It's the spark plug.
No, that's not it. I just had that replaced.
Isn't improv supposed to be all about yes and?
Yes and what?
Dad, stop. None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
Something about stories told by idiots, full of sound and fury, signifying fuck all.
Nailed it.
But I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself. Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Dad?
Relax, sweetie. It's all pretend, right?
Right.
Just a bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me. Look at me, sweetheart. It's going to be okay.
Wow. One hell of a nightmare. You say squish.
I saw Sarah leaving Frank's RV. He might know how to find her. He might also be totally pissed about Damon's money. I've got to get this exactly right. I can do this.
Price.
Whoa, Frank. Eager much? I have a question to ask you first. I mean, a favor.
You can't be fucking serious.
I need to find that woman who was in your RV yesterday. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help? I would really appreciate it. I'm your favorite client, remember?
I'll be in the junkyard in 2 hours.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real... That went well, I guess. What am I getting myself into?
Thank you.
Okay, I've got 2 hours to kill. Mom usually does my laundry when she gets sick of me not doing my laundry. Maybe she believed me for once about never coming back home. Better than nothing. Sorry, Ward. I've got a real ride to fix up now. Figures. What? Nice to see my work is appreciated. Rachel really is good at everything she does. Thou art an idiot. Whoa. Skip's in a band?
So you actually can't click on the link, but okay.
So much has changed. I wonder if you'd even recognize me now. I wonder if that's the universe where Dad's alive and Rachel has 3 happy parents. I'm about to rack up a lot more absences. Inaccurate as of yesterday. Someone should update this photo. It's way too early to be up on a Sunday. Dad's favorite jacket. Definitely taking that if Rachel and I ever leave. Is Mom playing music? Is that David's towel? Where the hell is mine? Okay. No awesome pirate towel. Lots of washcloths. No towel. I truly hate seeing so much of David's shitter. Gross. Score. Can't believe Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids. Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate, but we never got around to it. Ready for the best shower of my...
Oh, see, this is when she dyes her hair.
You'll be
do I feel like wearing on this crazy ass day? All right. One last thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck. Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs. If Rachel and I were still leaving today, there's literally nothing in there that's worth taking. Here goes. What are the chances I can avoid Mom or David?
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you, 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess. You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
You cook all the time. I want you to have a break at home.
You are one class act, David Madsen.
Mom actually looks pretty happy right now.
Hey, who's there?
Hey.
Chloe, your hair. When did you... Was this for the play? I heard you performed last night.
Nope. I mean, I did. But this is something different.
None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
I'm also glad you came home, Chloe.
I'm not staying long. Just picking up some stuff.
Oh. Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
I'm just hanging out with Rachel.
Oh, how is Rachel? I was telling David about the play and you being in it.
I really gotta go.
Listen, wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you. It won't take but a minute.
Mom.
It's funny because you don't realize until the second that David's not actually a dick.
Chloe.
I don't have time for this.
Now, hold on a minute. Please. I owe you an apology.
Let's hear it.
Chloe, I should not have asked you to empty your pockets yesterday. I was, out of line, and I'm sorry.
Okay. Apology accepted.
Really?
Yeah. Good job. And good job, Mom, for twisting his arm or whatever.
Chloe.
What? It's great. He listens to you. Can we be done now?
Wait, one second. Don't go, Chloe. I've been meaning to show you something. Maybe now's a good time. This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used to joke about all the trouble we were gonna get into once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day. The point is, I've had my share of grief. I know what you're going through. So I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here to do whatever I can to help you get over the loss of your dad.
Please, I'm begging you. Give David a chance, won't you?
Here. Why don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
David looks so young. And this Phil guy. They look close. Thank you, David.
Oh, Chloe.
Mom.
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Be careful out there, Chloe.
I love you, sweetheart.
All right, all right. What the hell? Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck. With me here. Damn it. Better, but still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast. I just...
need to find the right tool for each problem. It's not like I need a manual, but I'm really glad it's here. Looks like someone tried to patch this thing up sometime before I was born. At this point, I think that ancient duct tape is better than anything I can do. Better leave it be. This thing is gunked the fuck up. It's pretty loose. How can I tighten it? Much better. This connection is pretty shaky. I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it. Not helping. There. Fits like a deadly electric glove. This thing seems pretty gunked up. I think I should move on to something else. The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap. That should help keep shit distributed. Well, fuck. Go back from whence you came. Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Of course. Please, I need you.
Junkyard Queen, where are you at?
Hey. Holy shit. Your hair. It's so... badass. I was gonna say hot. But, yeah, badass too.
That shirt looks awesome too, I might add.
You like anything that starts fire.
Hey, not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck.
No way.
Should we check it out?
Isn't Frank supposed to be stopping by?
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his fucking bar mitzvah. Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
What's he doing here?
What do you think? We're not dealing with a couple of dime bags anymore, Chloe. Where's the money?
It's right here. Obviously, I was gonna give it to you. You don't have to be such a dick about it.
You heard what happened to Drew, right? Maybe try keeping that in mind when you talk to me.
Don't fucking touch her.
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly, it's a whole other thing. Frank says you were asking about a client of his. That true?
Yeah, it's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't? Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy, but that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you, but he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know right now. why you give a shit about this woman.
She's a friend. An old family friend.
This chick doesn't have any family. Or any friends.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it?
No. Tell me where she is now,
Rachel.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your problem?
Rachel? As in Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon.
Your dad's a real piece of shit, you know.
So? We don't have anything to do with him.
Right. Here's what happens next.
Come on, man. They're just kids.
No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking. Everything's still cool. No need to get crazy.
You fucking bitch!
Rachel is going to be all right. The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's out of surgery, and now she's resting. Chloe, what happened?
I don't know. Everything happened so fast. Do you know who Damon Merrick is? Or why he hates you?
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is. Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe. But I need the whole story.
So, I got my dealer to meet us, since he knows Sarah.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
I think he wanted to scare us, so he'd stop asking questions about his business.
Is that how it became violent?
It was actually Rachel who got angry. She was curious that he wouldn't tell her where Sarah was.
This is exactly what I've been afraid of. Rachel won't let anything stop her.
It wasn't only that. She was already angry about Damon pushing me around.
She is like her mother. Quick-tempered, rash. I've always been afraid of losing her the way I lost Sarah. What happened next?
Damon had a knife out. We all could see it. But then he said something that pissed Rachel off. And she just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her. I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something, but when he attacked her, I just froze.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream, but I don't know what happened. And then we were here.
I appreciate you telling me the truth. I'll see if I can pull some strings with Ray. Maybe get you back into Blackwell.
What if Rachel still wants to meet Sarah?
After all this, I'm hoping she'll finally see reason. I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, she might not have, Thank you, Chloe. You saved my world. It will be some time before Rachel wakes up. I promise. I'll let you know when she does.
Okay. Thanks.
She managed to get no blood on her.
Hey.
Steph. How's Drew?
Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay. I'm really glad.
Yeah.
Well, our room's just down the hall. You should come by.
Okay. Sure. Definitely. I don't think I can sit still any longer. Might as well
stretched my leg. Mom brought so many of these home when Dad died. And not a single one described how I felt. Being in a hospital this long sucks. I just want Rachel to wake up, and then I'll feel better. I owe Frank big time. Can't believe he did that for us. I hope he's okay. Not like I can do anything about it one way or the other. And what about Damon? Is he gonna come after us? I actually feel better knowing that James Amber is on his case. Ugh. That's weird. Frank's business must be booming. Shit. I really hope he's okay. Sean Prescott. What's he writing to the hospital about? I wonder if Damon Merrick classifies as a biohazard. He's definitely human waste. Is that Mikey and Drew's dad? I wonder how he's doing. Is this Drew's room?
All right then. Thank you.
Hi. Mr. North?
That's me. And you are?
I'm Chloe.
Here to see Drew?
Yeah. How are things going?
Oh, you know how it is. Ups and downs. You know, Drew's hurt, of course. But, I'm between jobs, so got plenty of time to visit. You know?
Yeah.
Hold on. You said you were Chloe. Mikey's mentioned you a few times now. I have a question maybe you can answer.
Sure.
Both of those boys have been acting a little, well, guilty lately. Yeah, I've been spending most of my time looking for work. I'm worried I missed something important. Do you know if anything's going on with them?
You should probably ask Drew. I don't really know any details. I do know that whatever it is, they did it because they wanted to help you.
Thanks, Chloe. I know they've been trying to help me out, money-wise. We're a family, you know? We deal with things together. Oh, excuse me.
Hey!
You made it.
Oh. Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Drew. How's your knee doing? Do they think it's gonna heal?
I'm not sure, actually. It's too early to tell.
Sorry to hear it.
It's all good.
Love the hair, by the way.
Pretty cool.
I figured it might fit with my new barbarian look. You know, war paint.
Awesome.
Nerds.
Hey, any news about Rachel? Her mom seemed hopeful.
Rachel's stable. She'll probably wake up soon.
How'd she get hurt?
You'll think I'm joking when I tell you, but I'm not.
What happened?
She got stabbed in the arm by Damon fucking Merrick.
Seriously?
It wasn't because of me, was it?
No, not at all. If anything, I should have thought about what happened to you before getting Rachel involved.
That's crazy.
Fuck that guy. I wish I could get my hands on him.
Drew, chill out, okay?
I'm headed out. Everything okay in here?
Yep.
Yeah. Don't have too much fun now. Try to keep it appropriate for the hospital.
Bye, Dad.
See ya, Pops.
Man. Maybe I shouldn't have mentioned Damon. Rachel's gonna be up soon. Should probably. I wanna eat that. Right now.
Hey. Sorry for losing it there. It's nice of you to come by.
Yeah, no problem. Easier than you coming to me.
You know what? I'm kind of tired.
Oh, right. I'll leave you alone. Those must be from Steph's parents.
I'm not gonna take his fucking pudding. I do want to get to graffiti his fucking leg though, but you know. Whatever.
Drew's been in a lot of pain today.
I think yep. Definitely too many concussions. I wonder if Drew will ever play again. Look at that. Wells being nice for a change. That'll be an interesting read. Damn. An 8 out of 10. All right. I'm gonna head out.
It was really great to see you, Chloe.
Agreed. Don't be a stranger, okay?
Yeah.
Tell Rachel we're rooting for her.
You bet. More like silent hospitals slowly drive friends and family insane.
Hey.
Those guys look exhausted.
Went out? You mean it's controlled? No. It's completely.
Unless you get stabbed. Hey.
Chloe, I can't even express thank you so much. I'm sorry. I'm a wreck. I stepped out to get some air. Rachel doesn't need me crying in front of her. Your hair. I almost didn't notice it.
Oh. Yeah. It's not a big deal.
I bet Rachel loves it. I can't imagine what I would do if we lost her.
Maybe you need to tell her that.
Me too.
You've grown so close, haven't you?
Yeah,
weird to think we just met a few days ago.
When you meet someone who changes everything, you just know.
Well, hang in there, Mrs. Amber.
I will.
Dad, I'm glad that you're here.
Me too, Rachel.
It really hurts.
Shh. The pain will pass. Chloe's here. You want me to stay?
No. I'll be okay. Thanks, Dad.
I'll come back in a little while.
My guardian angel.
I saw Steph earlier. She says hey.
Steph's so cute. But not as cute as you.
Stop.
I mean it.
Rachel, I'm sorry.
What? What for?
You're here because of me. Because I choked back there in the junkyard.
What? Shut up.
You were so fierce and I just froze. God, I fucked it up. I'm so sorry.
And you saved my life. You saved my life.
I almost lost you. I can't believe I almost...
You're not getting rid of me that easy.
Good. Happy that your dad's here?
I mean... I'm still mad at him for everything he's done. But it felt so good to lean on him. He's my dad, you know? I felt completely safe.
Like on Mount Hood.
Would you do something for me?
Anything.
Sarah. Mom. So weird to say. I'm not even sure what she is, honestly. But I think I still want to meet her.
Are you sure? She could be completely different than you imagine.
I'm sure. I don't even know if she's still in Arcadia Bay. But if she is, will you find her, please?
You really want this, don't you?
I do, Chloe. I really do.
Then, of course, whatever it takes.
I bet my dad has her number. Maybe in his office. Our house key's just under the mat. The code
is 0722. To your dad's office? 0722. Yeah. My birthday. I'll find her, Rachel. And then I'll tell her how fucking cool you are. Thank you, Chloe. For everything.
Oh, sorry, too soon.
Hey, Elliot.
Hey! Wait. Your hair, it's different.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like it. It's nice. I like your shirt, too. I didn't know you were into dragons.
Who the fuck isn't into dragons? Sorry I bailed on seeing the Tempest with you. The whole thing just sort of happened.
No. Not a problem at all.
Is that Hevel?
So, what's going on with you?
I don't even know where to start. At the moment, I'm here for Rachel.
What? Rachel's here? What happened?
I think she's keeping that private for now. She's okay, though.
Well, that's good. God, I guess I'll stop by after I see Drew.
She probably wants privacy.
Oh. Right, of course. Are you two in some kind of trouble? You can tell me if you are, you know. I won't judge.
I'll make sure to keep you posted. Right now, I'm here to take care of Rachel.
Chloe! I'm seriously worried about you.
Well, don't be.
I mean, you're hanging out with Rachel Amber a lot lately, right?
So what?
So, obviously, something is going on.
You get scared.
I swear, man, everything's really okay.
She's playing with my cat. He's biting my toes.
Okay. I trust you. Just remember I'm here, okay? If you suddenly need something.
Thanks. Anyway, see you around.
Yeah. See you around, Chloe.
That's the up button, not the down button. Bing.
Hello?
You really know there's no one there. They're both at the hospital. Okay, so apparently I can't stop her from...
I need to search this office for any communication with Sarah that can help me find her.
James has a file on Frank. I'd love to read this, but I've got to focus on finding Rachel's mom. Best dad. That stuff is all politics anyway. Sweet. The secret key. Now to find the secret lock.
Do not eat my stuff.
I don't know if anyone else is out there, but cats are insane. Love him to pieces, but doesn't mean he's not nuts. Okay.
Locked drawer inside locked office. Seems promising. Welcome to Shadyville. To know who James is talking to on the secret phone of his. It could be about Sarah.
Oh, it's obviously that is.
James is working with Damon Merrick? This is insane. What were they talking about? Is the girl Damon's talking about Sarah? Whatever is going on, I need to see if Damon knows where Sarah is. But how do I get him to tell me? I say, hope James actually has this evidence. James sure keeps lots of files on people. Even if James is trying to protect Rachel from her mother, this seems like a pretty terrible way to act.
Hmm. No, I'm not gonna go.
I guess
that.
Getting your ass kissed comes with the DA territory. More sherry. Arcadia Bay's least wanted. This must be what Damon was talking about. Shit. Which of these is Damon talking about? I could just take a wild guess and see what he says.
Straight away, you said about this.
If I can figure out how. How do I destroy a glove? Maybe I can burn it somehow. Better not touch that again. I hope James has something here to tell me who Damon's informant is. So I need to find which of Damon's guys has been snitching. I should search around the office to see if there's an Arcadia Bay's least wanted. I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy. This is that freak from the mill. Wonder what Damon would think of his very cooperative comment. Okay, there's no way that Frank is snitching on Damon, but I love learning about his badass loitering charge. Arcadia Bay's least wanted. Hope James doesn't really get Damon off the hook. That dude's gotta pay. Sarah sent all these letters, and James never gave them to Rachel? The Sarah in this letter doesn't seem anything at all. So, this looks like Sarah stopped cashing the checks James sent her. Guess he forgot to mention that during his story last night. Man, this guy's the snitch. He was so cool to me at the mill. Wonder if there's someone else I could pin it on instead. I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy. Guess I'm lucky James keeps so much info at home. I agree to aid the courts on future cases. That could be seen as a little snitchy. Looks like a recent man, this guy's the snitch. He was so cool to me at the mill. Okay. If I'm going to accuse one of these guys, I'd better be sure I'm right.
Sheldon?
This guy looks like a real tool. This guy let me into the mill. Cool dude. Could this douchebag be the snitch Damon's talking about? Guess this explains why Mr. Amber knows so much about Frank. Payment? Fuck. Here's hoping James already has Damon's money. But where would it be? Arcadia Bay's least wanted. Hope James doesn't really get Damon off the hook. That dude's gotta pay. Feels a little weird having this guy's records at my fingertips. Looks like a... Man. This guy's the... Guess I'm lucky James keeps so much info at home.
Okay, so how am I gonna find out?
I wonder if this has anything to do with Damon's stash.
Holy shit. Fuck, that's Sarah. And she's at the mill. What is he doing to her? Does James even know what he's doing? Okay, I still have time. Damon's waiting for his money, right? He wouldn't do anything to her. Yet. Fuck. I need to get there fast.
Chloe?
Elliot?
Hey!
Elliot, what are you doing here?
What are you doing here? This is Rachel's house, right?
Did he really just follow me here? Did you follow me from the hospital?
I did. I'm worried about you.
I'm fine. You're the one acting crazy. You shouldn't be here.
Chloe, what is...
Elliot, put that down. You have no idea what you're dealing with.
And you do? Chloe, what have you gotten yourself into?
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a chance. What the hell are you doing?
I can't talk much about it. It has to do with Rachel's mother. Her real mother.
And that explains you breaking into the DA's home and having this?
Believe it or not, yes.
I'm so sick of you not seeing who Rachel really is. When will you realize what she's doing to you?
Elliot, just take a step back.
No. You need to listen to me. What has your relationship with her gotten you?
You don't know what you're talking about.
First night you hang out, what happens? You end up in a fight.
You don't know what you're talking about. Rachel saved my ass.
I'm sure that's how it seemed to you.
Stop suggesting that she's somehow bad.
The next day she convinces you to skip school. Magically, she barely gets in trouble. And you get expelled.
I took the fall because I wanted to. Rachel tried to protect me.
Yet somehow, it all worked out for her in the end. As usual.
You don't understand. You weren't there.
Was she protecting you when she made you take part in a play you didn't want to be in?
Look, I'm sorry I ditched you for the play, but...
This isn't about that!
Seriously, man. You need to shut the fuck up before...
I've been quiet long enough! Look, Rachel is an amazing actress, and I don't mean on stage. She's
fake. You're real. And I hate to see her manipulate you like this.
Elliot. I promise. No one is manipulating me.
No? Just look where you are now. A high school dropout. Hanging out with criminals and breaking into houses. It's crazy. It just as easily could have been you in that hospital today. If that ever happened.
Look, I hear you. I appreciate the concern.
I don't think you do.
Elliot.
I'm the one who cares about you, Chloe. Me, not Rachel. It's time you saw the truth.
What does that mean?
It means you're going to stop thinking about Rachel and pay attention to me now, for once.
Elliot, please. I know you're upset, but...
I'm not upset! I'm trying to help you.
Elliot's gone full-blown crazy. I need to get the police to come without tipping him off.
Who was there for you? When Max left? When your dad died? No one else gave a shit about you except for me. We have a lot to talk about. And I don't care how long it takes. We're not leaving until you see that I'm right.
All right, Elliot. You want to talk so bad? Let's talk.
What's really going on here? You can tell me.
Here's what's going on. We're at the DA's house, and we should probably leave before he comes back.
Don't worry. With Rachel in the hospital, James isn't coming anytime soon. I'm talking about your situation. Rachel is dangerous. You need to realize that.
You're right, Elliot. I didn't want to admit it before, but it's true. My life is in danger.
Thank you, Chloe. All I want is to help you. I'm glad you can finally see that.
You're right. I do need help. I need help immediately.
Hey, it's okay. I'm not going anywhere.
I feel trapped. Boxed in. I desperately want to leave this situation.
It takes a lot of guts to tell me all this. And I want you to know that I will always be there for you. No matter what.
It's the police.
Okay, don't panic. I'm sure they'll just want to ask us why we're here.
What do we do?
I'll talk to them. There's nothing to be concerned about.
Thank you, Elliot. You're a great friend.
We'll be right back.
So much destruction. All because Rachel got angry at her dad, who's been lying to her all her life. And he's still lying.
Hey, being a dad's tough.
That doesn't justify what he's done.
I'm just saying, I'd probably do anything to keep you safe.
Hey, Dad?
Yeah?
Did you ever lie to me? I don't mean telling me that ashtray I made for Mom wasn't a piece of crap. I mean, like, really lied about something that might hurt me to know.
What do you think?
I suppose everyone lies about big things. I mean, the stuff Mom doesn't know about me. So you probably lied too.
Would you love me less?
Of course not.
You sound pretty sure, sweetheart. You were pretty sure Mom would never fall in love with someone like David, too. Are you really ready to hear the answer to your question?
You know what, Dad? Never mind. I don't need to know.
Be the perfect dad?
How many people get to say that? No word. My ride, my tunes. Seriously going in to face Damon Merrick? All for Rachel? Am I crazy?
Hella crazy.
I'm glad you're here, Dad.
You don't want me to go?
No. I like the company. Besides, you don't want to miss this. Things are about to get real. Is that blood? Frank? Frank! I'll get you help, Frank. But first, I've gotta help Rachel's mom. Where the hell is Sarah? Where's the homicidal drug dealer, Spooky Deerhead? To see the bomb made it. No more beer, no more time. I've got to keep moving. Frank's couch is toast.
Shut up. James Amber wants you out of the picture, so that's what's going to happen.
This is so messed up.
After all, no one believes a junkie.
No.
He said you've been sober a year. Respect. It's hard to kick this shit.
You can do this. Damon.
What the hell are you doing here?
I've got your money right here. The money James owes you.
How the fuck do you...
Run!
No one has to know. Just let her go, and I won't say...
Talking's over.
Leave her alone!
Shut up. What the fuck? You boosted the DA's shit? Got my money? Burned the evidence? All that?
I'm just trying to help.
Get away from her!
I said shut the fuck up!
No!
Go to your fucking happy place.
Run.
Let this be a lesson, kid. Make good life choices, or you'll end up like her. Now, what do I do with...
Damon! What did you do?
I fucked you up good, didn't I? Guess you really don't know when to quit. Glad to see you back on your feet.
Chloe.
Frank.
You don't really want to do this again, do you? Okay. Then I don't want to do this again. Come on, man.
Fuck you.
Sarah. Rachel. Your daughter. She...
Sarah? Chloe Price. You know who I am? I saw you in the play. You were funny. Thanks. Sit. Sarah, are you okay? We need to talk about what happened. I am so, so sorry for Rachel. Can never know. What exactly can't Rachel know? What James did. Hiring that thug. Shooting me up with... He's a piece of shit. And I promise that Rachel can never know. Tell me why. Doesn't she deserve to know what her father did? No. Rachel deserves a loving father. A father who cares for her. James is a liar. James is a desperate man who loves his daughter. And she loves him. Tell her what happened here, and you'll take that away from her. Forever. And just what is James protecting her from? You? She wants to meet you, Sarah. No, she doesn't. She wants to meet her mother. I can never be that for her. Why are you saying all this? Because James is right. He's taken something from me that I might not ever get back. But he's right. I'm broken. Everybody's broken, Sarah. Oh? Does everybody abandon their own child for 15 years? Does everybody take money to stay away? You're here now. That's what matters. What do you know? I know Rachel needs you. I... No loss. I lost my father 2 years ago. How? Car accident. He was picking up my mother from the grocery store, and a truck ran a red light, and was it? I'm sorry. You don't know what this is to me. Every pain. Every fear. Gone. No more sadness. No more grief. Why would anyone not want to feel that way? Ever. I read your letter to James. You beat this before. You can beat it again. No. I can't. I recognize I might not know what the fuck I'm talking about here, but I just... I wish you could know how amazing Rachel is. I know. She's fearless. She's brilliant and talented. And she feels so much. She's so strong. She's had a good life. Raised in a loving home, given opportunities I could never give her. At least talk to her. She's felt like something's been missing her whole life. She told me so.
That something was you.
She didn't miss anything. She has a perfect family.
I used to think my dad was perfect. But now I realize he was probably just as messed up as everyone. And it doesn't make me love him any less.
That's a nice thought. What Rachel needs, though, is not to have her father taken away from her.
He doesn't deserve...
It's not about James. It's not about me, and it's not about you. It's about Rachel. Tell her what James did, and you'll be killing him for her. You understand that, don't you? You lost your father. Do you really want to put Rachel through that?
The worst mistake you ever made was giving Rachel up. That's what you said in your letter to her.
You read that.
You don't have to make the same mistake twice.
Nothing can change the mistakes I made. I'll never get to be Rachel's mother. No. But there's one thing I can still do for you. The only thing I can do. Let me give her the father she deserves. The one who raised her, protected her. The one who loves her more than anything. You can do whatever you want, Chloe. You have the power. What you have to decide is whether you're going to protect Rachel or cause her even more hurt. So please, tell her I was never here. Let her have what peace she can without me.
Wait! I'll take care of her, you know.
I believe you. Goodbye, Chloe.
Hello?
Hi, Chloe. Rachel's just fallen asleep.
I know she'll be thrilled to see you when she wakes up. Maybe come back a little later?
Hey.
Go back to sleep.
Can I talk to Chloe? Alone? For a minute?
Okay, sweetie. We'll be right outside.
How are you feeling? Like I got stabbed? Doc says there'll be a sick scar. Maybe a tattoo is in order.
Fuck yeah.
We never actually escaped, did we?
We've got time.
all the time in the world. So, how did everything go? Rachel, I've got to tell you something. Hey. What's wrong? I failed you. I couldn't find her. I'm so sorry. Funny. You seem so confident. I really thought you'd find her. Yeah. Me too. Maybe we can try tomorrow. Maybe she hasn't left town yet. Of course. I know. Wherever she is, she loves you very much. How do you know that? Because why should she be any different from the rest of us?
okay, so she didn't get a tattoo for the inside of the arm where she was stabbed.
That one.